Good morning girls, now we come to our next exercise, exercise 1H, which is about estimating the quotient. Till now we have done the estimation of the numbers and then doing the addition, subtraction and multiplication. Now we will learn how to estimate the numbers and doing the division. Girls, in division process, what we have to do is that we have to make the dividend or both divisor and dividend into such compatible numbers so that they can be divided by each other. Now what does that mean? We will understand by an example. Suppose it is given 410 divided by 7. We know that 410 cannot be divided by 7, right? It will not give a whole number. So we will convert here only the dividend into such a number which is close to it, which can be easily divided by 7. Now, what is the number that is close to 410? That is 420. Right? 420 can be divided by 7. Here we have not changed the divisor. We have only changed the dividend. Okay. So it will give you 60. Is that clear? Okay. Now, second example what we will take here. It is given 5598 divided by 689. Right? So here, what is the number which is closer to 5598, which can be divided by 689? Also, we will change to a number which is closer to 689 so that both the numbers can be easily divided. So here we have changed it to 5600 divided by 700, which gives you 8. Both the numbers, now this can be easily divisible by 700. Okay. So, we have to convert the divisor and the dividend, sometimes only the dividend, into such a number which is closer to that and which can be easily divided by the divisor. Clear? We'll do the exercise and then it will be more clear to you. Now, we come to the first question in which we will do the A part, C part and E part. Now, A part, it is given that 331 divided by 4. Here, they have already estimated the dividend. What they have done? They have estimated it to 320 because 320 is closer to 331 and it can be easily divided by 4. Okay, so what it will give you? It will give you, the answer will be 80. Now we come to the C part. In C part, it is 375 divided by 12. So here again, what they have done? They have just estimated or rounded off the dividend. Okay, so the number near to 375, which can be easily divided by 12, is 360. 360 divided by 12 and it gives you 30. The answer is 30. E part. Now here it is 44 and the dividend is 1571. Now in this case, they have converted both of them, both the dividend and the divisor. Dividend, they have converted it to 1600 because 1600 is closer to 1571. Divided by 44, they have converted it to 40. So that they both, this 1600 can be easily divided by 40. And the answer is 40. Clear? Now we will do the second question. A part. Second question, A part, it says 283 divided by 7. So here, what we will do, we will round off or we will bring a number which is close to the dividend, this 283, which can be easily divided by 7. So it will be 280 divided by 7. It gives you 40. Okay, now they are also saying we have to verify by actual calculation. So let's do the actual calculation. So you will write here the verification. Okay, 283 divided by 7, it gives you 40.4. so that means it is approximately 40, isn't it? Approximately 40, and that only we have got it. This is also an estimation. So approximate of value of 40.440 will be 40 only. So this is hence verified. We have got the correct answer. Okay. Now we come to the B part. B part says 314 divided by 6. Again, what we are doing? We are converting this dividend into a number which is close to it and which is easily divisible by 6. So we have converted into 300. 300 divided by 6 gives you 50. Now let's do the verification. 314 divided by 6 gives you 52.3. So the estimation of this, what is it close to? 52. 52, if we round it off, we will get 50. Isn't it? So hence verified. Now the E part says 2758 divided by 96. Now what we are doing here, we are converting both of them to such numbers which can be divided by each other. So this 2758, we are converting it to 2800 because 2800 is near to it, divided by 100. So it will give you answer 28. Let's do the verification. 2758 divided by 96 gives you 28.72. That is, it is approximately 28 what we have got here. So here, hence verified. Right. Now you can ask me a question, ma'am. Why can't we convert it into 2700? Why have we converted into 2800 only? Because 2700 is also divisible by 100. We are changing it to 100. So 2700 is also divisible. Why haven't we changed this to 2700? The reason is, just compare the two numbers, 2800 and 2700. Which one is closer to 2758? 2758 has crossed the 50, 2750. Okay, so it is this number, 2800, is more closer to this rather than 2700. That's why we have taken here 2800. We have to take a number which is more closer to it and which is divisible also. Right? Okay. Now we come to the H part. H part says 5294 divided by 128. Okay. So what we will do here is that we will take this number as 5200. Okay. Now you can say, ma'am, why haven't we taken as 5300? Because 5300 is much closer to it, right? We are not taking it because this 5200, we are changing this into 130. Why not 120? Because 5200 would not have been divisible by 120. We have to bring both the numbers closer to these, but they have to be divisible by each other also. That is also a condition. That's why we are bringing it to 5200. And this we are converting into 130, right? And the answer comes to 40. Now let's do the verification. If we divide 5294 by 128, it gives you 41.35. That is, it is approximately around 40. It is closer to 40 only. Hence, verified. Clear? Now the remaining parts of this second question, that is the C part, D part, F and G. G is a repetition only. So these three parts are cancelled. We will not do these three parts, neither in the homework copy. So these only we have to do in the classwork copy. Is that clear? And girls, whenever you see a video, just give your comments that you have understood it or you have followed it on the YouTube channel by my name. Okay, you go on the YouTube, you see the video there and you give the comments so that I can know that you have followed it or you have understood it.